Good afternoon from the London International Media Hub, and good evening to our participants in Asia. As my colleague said, my name is Zed Tarar. I'm the Deputy Director here at the Hub, and I'd like to welcome everyone to this telephonic press briefing with Deputy Secretary of State Stephen Biegun. Please note this briefing is being recorded, and the recording and transcript will be sent to all attendees. Later on, we will open up for questions and answers. To be entered into the question queue, you will press 1 and then 0 on your keypad. With that, I'd now like to turn it over to our speaker, the Deputy Secretary of State, Stephen Biegun. The question comes from Mushfiskul Fazl from Just News BD.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Deputy Secretary Mr. Biegun, for visiting Bangladesh. I am originally from Bangladesh, based in Washington, D.C., working for Just News BD as a State Department and White House correspondent. I think you had the opportunity to observe the country's situation very closely during this visit. Democracy, rule of law, and human rights situation is very vulnerable, as it is clearly mentioned in the U.S. State Department report. It is widely believed last election was stolen, and ruling authority did not allow State Department organized election observers, and the U.S. expressed disappointment just after the election. My question, what is your present position on Bangladesh as ruling government is on zero tolerance on freedom of expression? What was your call to the authority to return back to democracy with holding a free, fair, and credible election, as the U.S. is the largest development partner of Bangladesh, one of the largest development partners? Thank you.
Thank you very much. I did have some very good discussions about a wide range of issues with the Bangladeshi government and also civil society, and I had a chance separately to meet with independent media and have a discussion with them about the current state of affairs in Bangladesh. Let me just say that it's my confirmed belief, it's the United States view, that Bangladesh's future lies in the path to democracy. That Bangladesh, what distinguishes Bangladesh as a leader in South Asia has been Bangladesh's constant efforts to advance towards democracy through 50 years of independence, through military dictatorships, through coups. Still, the goal of perfecting democracy remains a critical element of a bright future for Belarus, and it's certainly one that the United States is going to provide every assistance and encouragement for. Of course, that message is one that echoed in some of my meetings in Bangladesh. But the United States wants to work with the Bangladeshi government to get to this state. We are fully cognizant that Bangladesh is advancing in a region which has not always been hospitable to democracy, and building a democratic culture and having it sink in and sustaining it over a course of numerous elections is a challenge that every nation has to confront on its own, and in the case of Bangladesh, that's no different. So I'd be careful not to make a profound judgment about Bangladesh as a snapshot in the current moment, but rather look at in the larger continuum of what we want for Bangladesh and what we believe the Bangladeshi people themselves want for their own country. I'm confident that deepening our relationship, that continuing to give voice and example to our own values here in the United States of America, to having an open ear to the government as well as civil society in Bangladesh are the best ways that we can produce that outcome, and rest assured that we will continue in that journey with the people of Bangladesh and with the government to achieve the best possible form of democracy in that nation.
Thank you.